Hello and welcome to this lesson. In this lesson, I'm going to cover the IAM Identity Center. Identity Center is becoming a very important product on AWS, and in many ways, AWS is steering us towards using Identity Center instead of IAM for many use cases. Identity Center is the successor to the AWS Single Sign-On Service, AWS SSO. It's basically the same product, but renamed. And it enables centralized permissions management and single sign-on. So that means we can utilize Identity Center for single sign-on with many different other providers and business applications. Now, the identity source itself, so where the user identities are stored, can be Identity Center directory. It can be Active Directory and standard providers that use the SAML 2.0 protocol. Now, for Identity Center to connect to an on-premises managed directory, you can use the AD connector or AWS Managed Microsoft AD, depending on your requirements. There's then built-in single sign-on integrations to many different common business applications. And we get single sign-on to different AWS accounts, including accounts that are part of an organization. So let's have a look at a comparison between IAM and Identity Center. IAM is for managing access to AWS services and resources. Identity Center provides that centralized identity management and single sign-on, not just to AWS services, but then to other external services, other accounts, and business applications. Now, for Identity Federation, IAM supports federation to external identity providers using SAML, the Security Assertion Markup Language, and OpenID Connect. Identity Center builds on that with built-in federation with external IDPs, and it's streamlined for ease of setup and management, so it's easier to get it up and running. In terms of multi-account access, with IAM, it requires a bit more of a complex setup. We need to do things like assuming roles across accounts. With Identity Center, it's easier to grant users access to multiple accounts and applications with a single login. We then have integration with business applications. IAM, not really there. It's limited to AWS services. There can be some integration, but it's more of a custom setup, so it's a bit more complex. Whereas with Identity Center, this is exactly what it's there for. It's built, it has those built-in single sign-on capabilities to a lot of different business applications. For example, here we have Salesforce and Office 365, as well as AWS accounts as well. So much easier with Identity Center. So at the bottom here, of course, single sign-on, that's what Identity Center is all about. You can do it through federation with IAM, but again, it's a bit more complex, whereas Identity Center is built specifically for this purpose. In terms of use cases, with IAM, it's about managing AWS resources and permissions and creating and managing IAM users and roles within AWS, and then federating with external identity providers for single sign-on to AWS. So you might have your identities in an Active Directory, for example. You can then create that integration through federation into AWS, and then you get access from those user identities in your AD into AWS services. But really, it kind of is limited to that. It's harder to then gain access to other accounts and business applications. You've got programmatic access management and fine-grained access control through policies. We can get right down to a very detailed level in terms of the permissions we want to assign. With Identity Center, it's all about single sign-on, not just to AWS resources and accounts, but to non-AWS applications as well. And it's a centralized identity management. So if you've got a complex environment, it's going to be better to use Identity Center. And it also helps you with integrating with external directory services, making things easier. And again, ease of access to those business applications from a single sign-on perspective, because that's exactly what it's built to do. And lastly, Identity Center provides a nice user experience with a user portal as well.